today on my test field, testing a new app where we can take gigapixel panoramas with the 45mm lens with two batteries, waypoint mission, so we can repeat the panorama. We can go back on the second shooting on the exact same position, same altitude, same heading direction to take the second panel. And all is full spheric. I use the 45mm with a special weight to balance the lens. We need two batteries for one panorama. You will see that later on the video shooting from the app, where we can split the panorama in two missions. In the first shooting, go up with the Go 4 app and make really sharp the lens. That's very important. We cannot do that in the split pan app. It's best to use the Go 4 app to do that. Here we can see the app screen. We start the first panorama with 84 images. So the rows and columns are calculated full automatic depending on the lens. This app works with the X7 or X5S2, but it needs at last 35mm lenses. We have GPS coordinates on the screen. The first row at plus 30 degrees is made with the aircraft, and then the rest of the panorama is made with gimbal yaw. We can see that here we switch now to gimbal yaw. We turn forward the gimbal 180 degrees so that we have the full range for the 360 degrees left-right shooting from the gimbal. Today it was a little bit windy, as you can see on the screen, but with gimbal yaw that's not really a problem, and you can always check on the screen aircraft yaw and the relative gimbal yaw to see how the drone moves. If we don't use a full spherical grid to take panoramas like this, we will have more than 230 pictures to make, and that's not possible, and that it's not good for the stitching result. So the full spherical grid has the advantage that we have always the same overlapping and the shooting time is faster. But we cannot make a shooting with only one battery. That's not possible, and that's also not secure to do that. So now let's change the battery and start for the second shooting. In the first shooting, the coordinates, the GPS coordinates and also the altitude is saved. And if we launch the mission, we will first have a waypoint mission, and the drone goes back exactly to the point where we took the first shooting. We can see that now. And when the aircraft arrives on the GPS coordinates, the heading is resetted to the first shooting. For the second shooting, for this lens, we used 99 images. There is a distance control between the first shooting and the actual aircraft position. If this distance is too high, the aircraft will not proceed the mission. That's a security I built in the code. So if you are more than 200 meters away from the first shooting, the drone will not proceed for the mission. So for this shooting, it takes 183 images. Without the sky shooting. Sky shooting can be made with Osmo or tripod gears. But when the sky is blue as today, I fill automatically in Photoshop the sky. We need at last 55 pixels per line for a gigapixel panorama. And with the 45mm lens, we can make 7,000-8,000 pixels per line. At the end of the shooting, we save the XML file, so we can use it later to stitch together the image with XML import in Autopano Giga. So for this shooting, I didn't use the Osmo. As you can see here, we have 78,000 pixels per line for this shooting, and that's the final result from this panorama. the quality of these pictures is for professional use. You can produce large pictures with this resolution, and on web viewing you can really zoom in like on Google Earth. So the connection is quite fast. There are a lot of security checks. This app arrives when SDK 4.5 is ready, as we have actually a problem with Inspire 2 and Gimbal.io. It will be reserved for Inspire drones and more than 35 mm focal length.